37% of young people in Britain would like to live under a socialist economic system, according to a recent survey carried out by a right-wing think tank.
But humans are too selfish for socialism,
cried the right-wing, who like to imagine that everyone else has the same sort of awful personalities and mutilated souls as they do. It's basically the same argument that the right-wing have been making pretty much since the start of capitalism, when this rich white guy called Thomas Hobbes came up with his theory, State of Nature. This idea that humans are essentially just selfish brutes who need people in power to civilise us and keep us in check. And the theory became really popular with, surprise surprise, Western capitalist governments. It forms the basis of social contract theory, the philosophy of liberalism. And to prove their point today, the right wing often point to the many, many, many examples that sadly do exist of humans being really selfish to each other. They tell us it's always been this way and it always will. Human nature is just a barrier to socialism. But that's where they're wrong. First off, human nature isn't fixed. It hasn't always been the same. It's actually varied massively throughout history in different types of systems. For most of the time that humans have existed, we lived in hunter-gatherer societies. Starting around 2.5 million years ago, we lived in these communities up until the Neolithic Revolution around 10,000 years ago. And we know from both archaeological and anthropological evidence that during this time, there was no planting of crops, no pottery, and no means of transportation. This meant that it wasn't possible for either the community or individual members of it to accumulate a surplus of resources over and above what was needed for day-to-day existence. And without a surplus, there could be no division of society into full-time rulers at the top and workers at the bottom. This only became possible later with the agricultural revolutions. In hunter-gatherer communities, everyone was involved in producing the necessities of life. There was no private property, no class divisions, and no rulers, and they were largely egalitarian. This led Friedrich Engels, who wrote the Communist Manifesto along with Marx, to term these societies primitive communism. And in fact, hunter-gatherer groups have survived until relatively recently with a similar way of life. Research from anthropologists shows many of these groups have sharing and cooperation at their heart, as opposed to the cutthroat competition promoted under capitalism. So why does this matter? Well, it shows us that greed is not ingrained in human nature. It's about what kind of society we live in. Capitalism encourages greed and competition and rewards it for a few at the top. Look at the housing crisis. In Britain, nearly 15 million people are living in crowded or non-decent housing. And yet, billionaires continue to make profits by either buying up housing stock as an investment to sit empty while hundreds of thousands are homeless, or renting it out to people who can't afford to buy because they're competing with billionaires who keep buying up all the housing stock. The truth is that if you create a system that rewards people being selfish, that's exactly what you'll get. And yet, even in this situation, there are still so many examples of people being kind and helpful and compassionate towards each other, even when it's not directly in their own self-interest. Look at the mutual aid groups that sprung up everywhere during the pandemic. Look at the key workers who put themselves at risk to help others. Look at the refugee solidarity initiatives in defiance of the racism at the top of society. That's because human nature, at its heart, is about cooperation. No matter how much this oppressive, racist, sexist capitalist system tries to destroy it. The right wing are scared of young people turning to socialism because they know that under a socialist system, we take their wealth off them. We'd also begin to really unleash humanity's potential by liberating the human spirit from the greed and misery caused by capitalism and building communities based on kindness, compassion, and cooperation.